crazy, lazy, busy, wish we in the flesh.
Where you from, nigga? Straight from the motherfucking land of the hogs. Five true thugs from the double Glock.
And you fuck.
Ready to pop to the dome.
Of course, I like Whitney. Definitely like them and all the little groups and shit, like New Edition. And
then before that, you know, it was New Edition, Michael Jackson.
Word.
You know, that's where the singing and all the Motown and all that shit.
Yeah, because
everything's mental.
All right, now, wait a minute. Now, that is what I want to ask about. What is this? What is it, our music?
What is mental?
No, what is the slogan. Our music is the
our music is mentally hip-hop, smoothed out on the R&B tip with a pop feel appeal to it.
Translation? and like, what does that mean?
That means that our music, first of all, hip-hop is mental. It's mm-hmm. from the street. It's the attitude.
Okay.
And so, therefore, our music is not just hip-hop, but it's hip-hop, but it's smoothed out on the R&B tip, you know. It has that R&B feel to it,
okay.
You know. And then once it becomes popular, it has that pop feel appeal to it, you know. It's able to cross over.
I think
so.
That's
what it all means. And you have to listen to the music mm-hmm. to understand what we're talking about, because that's how we came up with the slogan, by listening to the music.
So go get the album and listen to the music, and you'll be able to understand.
Exactly.
What do you think it is about your music that appeals to so many people? I mean, have you guys had a chance to try to analyze it?
I think it's really like the fans pin the real.
It's the way
they feel it. They pin the real, you know? Mm-hmm. Everybody out here saying this and that and doing this and that, but, you know, they pinning the real. They like that harmony, everything we're doing.
Nothing
and we
music.
Giving it to them, you know? We ain't just rapping. We doing it, you know, we giving it to them. Check that East 1999 turnaround, I guarantee.
That's right, well, that's the...
17 cut strong.
All brand new.
And he predicted it, I'm telling you. Last time he told, he on the intro, he told him, we coming to shut it down.
Nope.
He told him.
Look, everybody, all together, when is the last time that you saw New Edition, past and present? I think that deserves a round of applause. Hey.
All right.
This ball doesn't harm me. What the fuck you bringing up here, blind ass fuck?
Because
the owner can't even see. What you expect the team to do?
I wanted to know.
What's up with you and Bone?
I told you, we're in the studio.
Why'd y'all break up?
We ain't broke up. We got a brand new album coming out. Why don't you check it out?
There are many parallels between New Edition and Bone Thugs and Harmony. Breakups to makeups, successful solo careers, and plenty of controversy, and even high-profile deaths. I would even go as far to suggest that the success of the New Edition biopic film indirectly influenced the decision to make the Sons of St. Clair documentary, as well as Bone's Coming Someday biopic. I always felt that Bone was able to pull off what Bell Biv DeVoe had set out to do. BBD was sold to the rap audience as a hip-hop group, but real hip-hop fans weren't accepting it, and rappers EPMD and others even protested it. To pop and R&B, not the MD. I'm strictly hip-hop. I stick to kick a free. BBD was more R&B as the main course, with hip-hop as a side dish. Bone was more rap and hip-hop, with blends of R&B and other genres. But as New Edition was the most successful boy band of R&B of the 80s, Bone Thugs and Harmony are in ways the boy band of rap and dominated the 90s. Both groups have been multi-generationally successful as they both have had crossover appeal. But if we were comparing Bone to New Edition, who would be who? Let's start with the infamous Bobby Brown. I think everyone would unanimously nominate Bizzy Bone in that both of their initials are BB, both were the first to drop solo albums, and both were kicked out of the group for behavioral and other reasons. Next, we have Ronnie DeVoe. I'm placing Flesh and Bone as Ronnie DeVoe because DeVoe always felt like forever the fifth dog, and Flesh and Bone is forever the fifth dog. Also, they were like the most unique to look at. They always had a cool fashion sense. They enjoyed playing the background, and they had the coolest names. DeVoe, Flesh and Bone. All right, now we have Michael Bivens. I'm placing Layzie Bone as Michael Bivens because Biv is the undercover leader of the group, spawning other groups and projects, and is like the mastermind of all time, and went back and made sure to bring all of his other homies up. And since Biv and DeVoe are the two rappers, Layzie and Flesh are the two brothers, the Harmony House brothers. So, got to keep that part consistent. So Biv, like Layzie, is underappreciated for what he brought to the table. And now we have Ricky Bell. I'm placing Wishbone as Ricky Bell because while most people list Wish and Bell as their least favorite, they both have the most memorable lines in group history that everybody knows.
Now you know.
Your slick blow.
It's driving me.
Yeah, man, I miss my Uncle Charles, y'all. He should be gone in front of his home when they did the group was wrong.
They're also both the widest or largest guys in the group, and I feel most overlooked until they do something wrong.
I can teach the world to be a thug like me.
Johnny Gill. We're going to say Krayzie Bone is Johnny Gill for his vocal tone.
On a perfect day, I know that I can count.
Maturity and professionalism.
Hold up.
However, Ralph Tresvant is the wild card combination of half Krayzie Bone and half Bizzy Bone. Ralph Tresvant's singing tone range is similar to Bizzy Bone's. But his fashion style and leading role, lead singer of the group, is more Krayzie Bone. Another huge similarity between the two is the family tree. So New Edition spawned out the side groups of Bell Biv DeVoe, BBD, Boyz II Men, ABC, the East Coast Family, and then a super group called L.S.G., which was Gerald Levert, Keith Sweat, and Johnny Gill. Another super group called Heads of State, which was Johnny Gill, Ralph Tresvant, and Bobby Brown. And then they influenced Dallas Austin. We're connected to Terry Lewis and Jimmy Jam, Puff Daddy and Bad Boy, Dougie Fresh, Whitney Houston, and countless others. And then Bone Thugs and Harmony, you know the side groups they had. Mo Thug, Seven Sign, The Life Entertainment, Harmony House, and Flesh and Bone Global. But it seems like the blueprint that Bone followed possibly came from New Edition. So what do you think, Beyond the Harmony? In the comments below, leave your list of who each member of New Edition would be if they were Bone Thugs and Harmony. You know, I'm Jonathan Lippy, representing the Harmony, always trying to push that R&B and alternative flavor on the audience. I'm a line stepper. I'm a habitual line stepper. Nevertheless, I hope you enjoyed the ride, and I'll see you in the next one.
Beyond the Harmony, for the fans we celebrate.